Thanks for joining us tonight at 6. We start off with breaking news.
A Toledo couple is under investigation. You likely know the last name, the Tickmeyers, known for raising money for fallen officers.
And now the mother, Lisa, is being accused by state investigators of faking cancer and taking the money from fundraisers for herself. Our 11 Investigates team has been working day and night to bring you this story that you will only see tonight on WTOL 11.
Investigative reporter Kaylee Marantette is in studio tonight. Kaylee, this is something you might see in a movie.
It is, Melissa. We couldn't believe it when we first heard it, especially because so many people in our newsroom know the Tickmeyers. It's important to note that as of now, Lisa is under investigation, but she has so far not been charged with anything. But after reading through search warrants, a sworn affidavit, and talking to nearly a dozen people, we knew we had to share this story.
Known for generosity.
In his generation, he's showing kids what it is to give back.
The Tickmeyer family, Ryan, Lisa, and their two boys. The family claims they raised upwards of $14,000 for fallen Toledo police officers Anthony Dia and Brandon Stalker from hot cocoa and lemonade stands.
I actually met Lisa when Max did the lemonade stand for Officer Dia. We went through there and bought lemonade.
This is Dee Lynn. She lended a hand fundraising for the Dia and Stalker families, also wanting to help the Tickmeyers with their efforts. Except at a February hot cocoa stand, Dee learned the news.
That's when Lisa told me she had cancer.
Stage 2 non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. The Tickmeyer family, known for giving, now in a time of need. And the community didn't disappoint. According to a BCI agent's sworn affidavit, at least 4 different fundraisers were held over 4 months raising money for Lisa. August 2021, Wheelin' on the Rocks raised $5,200. September 2021, $3,500 was raised from a K100 lemonade stand. October 2021, St. Francis Soccer fundraiser for a total of $3,000. November 2021, an online event that collected more than $5,000, totaling nearly $17,000. That doesn't include all the cash donations, checks, mobile app contributions, and gift cards.
I didn't have no reason to doubt anything.
But doubt started to cloud people's thoughts of Lisa's diagnosis.
And one day she came to my house and she had her hair shaved, her head shaved, and I'm like, she's like, it was just falling out so bad, I had to. When I saw her with her head shaved, I'm like, well, there's hair follicle, and she's like telling me how she did it because it was thinning.
Family and friends of Lisa told 11 Investigates they offered to come to appointments with her, but she always turned them down. But the fundraising continued for years. Lisa claimed the cancer kept coming back, and bills were piling up as suspicions of her diagnosis never left. That's when the Ohio Bureau of Criminal Investigations got a tip. According to court documents, subpoenas were sent to Mercy Health, Toledo Clinic, and ProMedica for Lisa's cancer records. And no records of a cancer diagnosis or treatment were found.
I can't imagine why anyone would want to lie about cancer.
Through the fundraisers, the stories.
Set up a hot cocoa stand to raise money for the family of Officer Brandon Stalker.
Even fooling WTOL 11. Our team even tried to highlight Lisa's cancer battle after all the good she had done. Texting our Melissa Andrews about getting wigs, and that her hair was falling out. About being open about her diagnosis. And then a financial guy was coming over to talk about medical bills. Now there were bills the family had to pay, but for their house, as it faced foreclosure in September of 2023.
Only way I can describe her is Little House on the Prairie. You would never think it. She's got the sweet demeanor about her. You would never think it, especially after what you just did for the fallen officers.
In court documents, Lisa admitted she never had cancer or has been treated for cancer.
She needs to apologize to the public, to everyone that supported her through all this. It's not fair to them.
According to that affidavit, those search warrants indicated there was evidence to pursue 3 charges. Those include theft by deception, telecommunications fraud, and falsification in theft defense. But again, as of this evening, no charges have been filed yet. We have reached out to Lisa and Ryan a number of times, but have not heard anything back. We've also reached out to other family members who did not. want to comment. In studio, Kaylee Marantette, WTOL 11.